Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to practically demonstrate a Java program to check whether the given number is a prime number or not. So before we write a Java program, let me first explain what exactly is a prime number. Prime number is a number which is greater than 1 and also is not divisible by other numbers except 1 and itself. So if a number satisfies these two rules, then we can call that number as a prime number. If you take a number like 19, guys, is 19 greater than 1? Yes, first rule is satisfied for this number to become a prime number. Then what about second rule? Is not divisible by other than numbers except, okay, it should not be divisible by other numbers except 1 and itself. This number should be divisible by 1 and itself. It will be divisible. 119 is a 19. You will get the remainder 0. So this number is divisible by 1. What about itself? That means 19 itself. If you divide this number 19 with 19, will you get the remainder 0? 19 ones are 19. Yes, you will get the remainder 0. But is there any other number? Is there any other number which can divide this 19 evenly apart from 1 and itself? Is there any number which can divide this 19 and get a remainder 0? There is no number, guys. You cannot divide this 19 by 2 or 3 or 4. Okay. Only 1 and 19 can divide this number. 1 and itself can divide this number evenly by getting a remainder 0. All the other numbers cannot divide. Hence, 19 can be called as a prime number, guys. A number which is greater than 1 and also is divisible by only 1 and itself is known as a prime number. Now, let's write the Java program to check whether, based on these two rules, we'll write a logic to check whether the given number is a prime number or not. To get started, we need to intake the input from the user. Okay. This number, whatever the number that user inputs, we need to check whether that is a prime number or not. For intaking any input from the user, we need to create an object for the scanner class first. Scanner is equal to new scanner like this. We need to create an object for the scanner class over the mouse on scanner and import this scanner from java.util package. And this scanner constructor cannot be empty. We have to provide system.in to resolve the error. Once we resolve the error, we need to ask the user to enter any number like this. After looking at this particular text in the output, user will try to input a number like 19 or whatever it is. So once the user inputs this input, we need to intake this input into our Java program. By using the scanner object, we can intake this input into our Java program, scanner.in. There is a command known as nextint. Nextint command of the scanner class will intake the integer values as inputs from the user. Once this given input, integer input is intaken or captured by this nextint, we can store that into a variable here. Let's say I will store that as number, okay, num, create local variable. Now we have successfully received the input from the user, integer input from the user. Now we need to write the logic for checking whether the given number is a prime number or not. Okay. We need to write the logic for checking whether the given number is a prime number or not. How to check that? For that, we need to make sure that this given number is greater than 1 first. Okay. If number is greater than 1, this is the first rule, right? If otherwise, the number is not a prime number. If number is not greater than 1, the given number is not greater than 1, then that is not a prime number. So else part, if the given number is not greater than 1, then we'll directly print it out here. Okay. Instead of print it out, what we can do here is we'll create a Boolean value. Boolean is prime, like this. Okay. By default, we'll set that to false, or we'll set that to true, guys. Okay. Boolean is prime is true. By default, we'll set it to true. And if in case the given number is not greater than 1, then we'll go into the else block where we'll set this is prime as false. Sorry, I have to copy this is prime properly. If in case the given number is not greater than 1, one of the rule is not satisfying for this number to become a prime number. Hence, we'll mark this is prime as false. Now, what if the given number is greater than 1? In that case, we have to check one more thing. The second condition we have to check. whether this given number is divisible by only itself, one and itself, or any other number can divide this number. If any other number other than one and itself can divide this number, then this number is not a prime number, right? For that, we can create a for loop. For int I is equal to, okay, int I is equal to, anyhow, we can, there is an exemption like one and itself can divide this number. So we don't have to check with one. That's why I'm starting with two guys. The one will definitely divide this number evenly, and itself also can divide the number evenly. So we need to start dividing the given number starting from two ways, okay? Not one. One, definitely it will divide. That's fine. Then I less than or equal to, I is equal to, I less than or equal to, I less than number you have to say. You don't have to divide this number by itself, because anyhow, 19 will be divisible by any number if you give, that will be divisible by itself, right? There is no need to check it. If a number is not, is divisible by other than one and itself, that means starting from two to less than number, we have to iterate this for loop. I plus plus. Here for loop, write the for loop. So here, I'll say if, again, one more condition, if the given number percentile 2 is giving the remainder as 0, then say is prime is equal to false. Other than 1 and itself, if any other number can divide this number, that means you are starting dividing this number starting from other than 1 and itself, that is starting from 2 to less than number. Number minus 1, you can say, okay, 2 to number minus 1. If any of the numbers in the range of 2 to number minus 1 can divide this number evenly by giving the remainder as 0, then this number is not a prime number. So we have to set the is prime as false. Otherwise, is prime is true only, right? By default, is prime we have set is true, set as true. But if the number is not greater than 1, then it is false. It's not a prime number. And if the number is divisible by any other number other than 1 and itself, again, it is a false. So at the end of this logic, we'll write a if condition saying if is prime is true, then only we'll print the given number is a prime number. System.out.println, this number plus is a prime number. Else System.out.println, number plus is not a prime number. Simple, guys. So hope you understood the logic anyhow. So one more thing, we are done with the logic, guys, but before running this code, we have to make sure that this scanner object is closed. As part of the best practices, after collecting all the inputs, required inputs from the user, we have to simply close this scanner object. You see, the warning message got resolved, and also we followed the best practice. Though this is not mandatory, we have to do as part of the best practice. Now run this code. The program will ask the user for entering any number. Let's give some number like 19, guys. 19 is a prime number. So let's see whether this program works perfectly or not. You see, 19 is a prime number got printed. What if I give something like 10? A number 10. Is 10 a prime number? No, 10 is greater than 1. That's fine. But 10... apart from 1 and 10, 10 can be divided by 2, 10 can be divided by 5, right? So that's the reason 10 is not a prime number. 10 is not a prime number. So this program is working perfectly fine, guys. So hope, guys, you understood how to write a Java program to check whether the given number is a prime number or not. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.